In Pi Vision 2019, we built out functionality for the ad hoc workspace. Let's dive in and see what's new. I'm going to take a look at a wind farm display that I have at my site. We'll see that I have two sites, Northeast and Scirocco. And at my wind farm, I want to see how the wholesale prices compare. To work with our ad hoc workspace, we'll make sure that we're in a view mode and not in any build mode, as these trends are going to be built on the fly by your viewers. There's a few ways that I'm able to add items to my ad hoc workspace. The simplest is to click on whatever I'd like to add. And I can hold Control to select multiple items. Next, I can right-click and choose Add Selection to Ad Hoc Trend. There are now two new items that were added to my workspace, as shown in the top right corner. To open up my ad hoc workspace, I can click on that button. By default, you'll see that we're using multiple scales, as well as the plotted values if you look in the top left. I also have the option to convert to a single scale, as well as use database settings, which for data from AF will use the limits, or if you're using a Pi point from the data archive, it will use the zero and span. Let's go back to our plotted values. And let's say I wanted to alter the scale slightly to my exact specifications. I can click Enter, and now that I've changed the range manually, we can see that I'm using custom settings. We can use any combination of our custom ranges, as well as multiple or single scale options. If you'd like to remove objects from the trend, you can select the trash. If you'd simply like to hide them, you can just uncheck the box. If I made a mistake and want to undo, I have an undo button that I can use multiple times to bring back what I need. I can also change the time context at the bottom, and I can interact with the trend the same way that I would for other trends built outside of my ad hoc workspace. I can drop multiple cursors and find the points that I'm most interested in seeing. Let's see a few other ways to add items to this ad hoc workspace. Clicking on the X in the top right corner will just hide my ad hoc workspace. What's nice is my ad hoc workspace is going to persist through my browser tab session. I'm free to go to another one of my displays and pull the data that I want to see in order to add it to the right ad hoc workspace. Let's go to my wind farm turbine overview. And I'd like to see the lifetime production in my ad hoc workspace. I can select the object or select multiple objects and click on the button at the top to add the selection to the ad hoc trend. Clicking so will immediately bring me to my ad hoc workspace. And although I don't see the trace in my trend, which is because I'm using a custom scale, I can see that it was added to the table. Let's adjust the scale settings and use the plotted values. I can see that the use of a single scale is going to make it too difficult for me to see the wholesale price, so I'll switch back to multiple scales. Now I can see multiple pieces of data coming from different displays all in the same ad hoc workspace. Yet another way to add items to my ad hoc workspace is to use my drill down on the left-hand side. So if I would like to see my lost power, I can right-click and add selection to the ad hoc trend. Again, we'll notice in the top right corner that we can go to our ad hoc workspace and it'll have one additional item. Now I can see the lost power and I can also clean up the trend however I'd like to see it. Additionally, you might want to share your findings with other coworkers. We've made a share button which will build out a URL. That way you can share your ad hoc workspace with one of your colleagues. Last but not least, if you'd like to save your ad hoc workspace and make it a display on its own, you can use Convert to Display. This is going to create a trend with all of your items on there, as well as a table below it, just like we're seeing here for the ad hoc workspace. When you're done configuring your ad hoc workspace, you can convert to the display and save it and share it as you normally would. We hope you enjoy the boosted functionality of our ad hoc workspace, and let us know how you're using the ad hoc workspace in the comments below.